Hi everyone, welcome to Mathematically Inclined. What if I tell you a trick in which you can get your answer in less than 5 seconds as I discuss with you the method which is 0 or 1 and you are done. 0? Forget it. Let's get started. Please note, today's video is going to be very action-packed as the questions I have selected are from JEE, state JEEs, NDA, MCET and lot of those competitive exams. Okay, so why do we call this 0 or 1? Basically, if you come across such questions, your target would be to create maximum zeros or maximum ones in the questions. Why? Because they make your calculations super simple. Let's check out this one. So if you are given A is 2 sine theta upon 1 plus cos theta plus sine theta, then you have to find out this huge looking expression where you don't really have to get into the traditional method. You have to carefully select theta, which would make your calculations very easy by making maximum terms as 0 or 1. Like in the first question, you know if you take your theta to be 0 degrees or 90 degrees, which works the best for sine theta or cos theta. So let me try theta as 0 degrees. That makes my A as 2 sine 0, so that's a 0, upon whatever defined. So this will be 1 plus cos 0 plus sine 0. So basically my A is 0. Once I take my A to be 0, let's check what this expression gives us. So 1 plus sine 0 is 0 minus cos 0 is 1 upon 1 plus sine 0. So ultimately I get a 0 again. I need to see which of these options give me a straight 0 when I put my value of A to be 0. So if you see, 1 upon 0 cannot be the answer, it will become not defined. A is 0 and this expression is also 0, so this goes. Just for a check, you know, 1 minus 0 gives us 1, which is not the answer. 1 plus 0 again gives us 1, which is not the answer. So the option was option B. Wasn't that easy? Now moving on to the second question, it says, if sine x plus cosecant x is equal to 2, so you're already given this condition, then what would this be? Now please note, I have to carefully select x so that I don't end up taking a value which makes it undefined. Like if I take x equal to 0 degrees, since sine 0 becomes 0 plus cosecant 0 becomes undefined and in any way, and it anyway doesn't match with 2. If I try taking x as 90 degrees, this becomes sine 90, which is 1, cosecant 90 again 1, this is 2. So that means x equal to 90 degrees works perfectly for us. Similarly, so now what you're going to do is, let's say try putting n as 2. If you try putting n as 2, your x has been chosen to be 90 degrees. So sine square 90 degrees plus cosecant square 90 degrees. It is still going to give you 1 plus 1, that is 2. Similarly, I try taking n as 3. It gives me sine cube 90 degrees plus cosecant cube 90 degrees, again 2. So whatever n I take, my answer is always 2. So without thinking, you know, this would be the answer. Okay, moving to the next one, it says if tan 3a upon tan a is equal to k, then you have to find the value of this. Now looking at the options, you might feel they look quite similar. But don't worry. Now, I have to choose the angle this way so that I can get a valid value for k. You can't certainly choose a to be a 0 because tan 0 is a 0, which in the denominator would make the things worse. If you try taking a as 90 degrees, again doesn't work because tan a is not defined. Tan 45 degrees works very well, because that makes this 1, but then at the same time this becomes tan 135 degrees. So you can still try out. What I am thinking to do in the question is, what if I take A to be 60 degrees? Because this makes it tan of 180 degrees upon tan 60 degrees equal to k. That means my k, tan 180 degrees is going to be a 0. You can check. Upon tan 60 degrees, even though it's root 3, it doesn't make a difference. So I get k to be a 0. Once I get k to be a 0, now I have to start putting it here. So I get sine of 180 degrees upon sine 60 degrees. Now if you check for sine 180 degrees, again it's a 0. So I have to see which of the options matches my answer 0. So if you try putting in any of these, you know you are going to get your value 0. However, this case, since your k is coming out to be 0, which is in the denominator, is certainly out. So I have A, B, C to be selected from. Now if you also see, it is k minus 1 in the denominator, so your k cannot be 1. Otherwise, it makes the term undefined. So all I'm going to do is, this goes out. Now the choice is between these two. If you look at this interval, 1 is here, and we are saying k cannot belong to it. So certainly this is the answer. Because if I try including this, this means k has to lie between 1 by 3 and 3. So that means k can take the value 1, which makes this undefined. So C is the answer. So by choosing an appropriate A, I could get the answer to be 0. That made me eliminate D, and then amongst A, B, C, we used our logic that k can't be 1 and thus got the answer in seconds. Trust me, explaining the trick takes very long, but I was able to solve it in less than 5 seconds. Please have a look. Now look at the fourth question. Since x and y are in terms of sine theta and cos theta, I can take anything, theta to be 0 or 90. Let's take 90 because that reduces our work. So if I take theta to be 90 degrees here, I get sine 90 plus cos 90. So definitely my x is a 1, and y simply becomes sine 90 into cos 90, so a 0. Wow. Now all I need to do is substitute for x and y in this huge expression, and that gives me an answer. So x is a 1 minus 4 into y, that becomes a 0, minus 2x square, which is minus 2, plus 4y square, which will be a 0, plus 4y, which is a 0, plus 1. So if you start simplifying, your 1 plus 1 minus 2, it's a 0. That's your answer. Wasn't that easy? So moving on to the next set of questions. Question 5 says, if sine square x plus sine square y is a 1, then what is cot of x plus y? So there are certain combinations we can take for x and y. Like x could be taken 0 degrees and y as 90 degrees. I'll still get 0 plus 1, which is 1. Or I can alternate 90 degrees and 0 degrees. I'll again get the answer 1. Also, it is a square. So even if I get half plus half, it is still a 1. So that means I can even take this to be 45 degrees each, because sine square 45 degrees gives me a half. Sine square 45 degrees here again gives me a half, which makes it 1. Your choice. So let's go with the simplest one. Let's say we start with this. So automatically that means your x is 0 and y is a 90 degree. So we have to find this. So cot of 0 plus 90 degrees means you have to find the value for cot 90 degrees. Cot 90, well, it is simple. It is a 0. So this is the answer. Now what do I do if I have all 6 trigonometric monsters in the same question? Have a look. I have sine A, I have cos A, secant A, cosecant A, cot A, tan A, everything. Which element should I take so that I don't make the expression undefined, but at the same time I save a lot of time? You certainly know when you have all 6 of them, you can't take A to be 0 degrees, because in that case your cosecant A would become undefined. You cannot take A to be 90 degrees because that makes your secant A to be undefined. However, with your tan, you know in order to create a 0 or 1, there is either you take A to be 0 or you can take A to be 45 degrees. So A equal to 45 degrees would be slightly complicated, but then works very well. So This makes it secant 45 degrees, that will give you a root 2, cos 45 degrees, that gives you a 1 by root 2 whole square, plus the same thing happens here. So root 2 minus 1 by root 2 whole square, and this one cot A minus tan A would be cot 45 minus tan 45, which is going to give you 1 minus 1, 0. So you need not even write all that. This one, if I take the LCM, is 2 minus 1. So that's 1 by root 2 whole square plus 1 by root 2 whole square. And I get the answer 1 very easily. Our video just can't be complete without the do-it-yourself questions. Yes, today I have 2 DIYs for you. You have to comment your answers in the section below. And this time I have a special announcement. The first one to get the answer correct, I would be naming that person in my next video. So let's see who does that first. Also, please note, I get a lot of comments, phone calls, WhatsApps, emails, and all that is really appreciated. But at the same time, please note, I am working and I have certain commitments, so at times I'm not able to take a lot of them. But at the same time, the intention is to help all of you. So make sure you tell me the topics which you want me to take up so that I can incorporate them, and that helps me a lot to create my content. I hope you understand that. With that, if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with people around you, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that so far. I will see you with my next video real soon. Until then, bye-bye.